Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you to the witnesses for your testimony today, for your bravery on January 6th, and for your service to our country. I know all of you endured a great deal on January 6th, and I know we've watched a lot of difficult video in this testimony so far, but I hope it's okay with you if I show a brief video of what Officer Hodges experienced that day. Can you please cue the video? Officer Hodges, I know that must have been difficult to watch, but I really think it's important for the American people to see that, because that's the beginning of the kind of accountability that this committee is committed to in order for us to do what you said, moving forward as a country. You know, January 6th was an attack on our democracy. It was an attack on the peaceful transfer of power, and it was an attack on this Capitol building, but it was also an attack on real people. And most people don't know this, and I don't think even you know this, but your actions had a profound impact on me. So at 3 p.m. on January 6th, while you were holding back the mob at the Lower West Terrace entrance, I was holed up with Congresswoman Kathleen Rice in a small office about 40 paces from the tunnel that you all were in. That's about from the distance where I'm sitting here on the dais to that back wall. And from that office, in close proximity to where you all held the line, I listened to you struggle. I listened to you yelling out to one another. I listened to you care for one another, directing people back to the makeshift eyewash station that was at the end of our hall. And then I listened to people coughing, having difficulty breathing, but I watched you and heard you all get back into the fight. And I think Congresswoman Rice and I were the only members of Congress to be down there on that Lower West Terrace. You know, we had taken refuge in that office because we thought for sure being in the basement at the heart of the Capitol was the safest place we could be. And it turned out we ended up at the center of the storm. And Officer Fanone, you had said, you know, you were 250 feet off of that tunnel and you felt certain that they were going to kill you. Imagine if they had caught the two members of Congress that were just 40 feet from where you all were. And I know Sergeant Gunnell and Officer Hodges, you both said that you didn't realize that other parts of the Capitol had been breached, but you really felt like you were the last line of defense. Well, I'm telling you that you were our last line of defense. And during the exact period of time, Officer Hodges, in that video where you were sacrificing your body to hold that door, it gave Congresswoman Rice and I and the Capitol Police officers who had been sent to extract us the freedom of movement on that hallway to escape down the other end of that hallway. And I shudder to think about what would have happened had you not held that line. You know, I have two young children. I have a 10-year-old son and a 7-year-old daughter. And they're the light of my life. And the reason I was able to hug them again was because of the courage that you and your fellow officers showed that day. And so just a really heartfelt thank you. I think it's important for everybody, though, to remember that the main reason rioters didn't harm any members of Congress was because they didn't encounter any members of Congress. And they didn't encounter any members of Congress because law enforcement officers did your jobs that day, and you did it well. I think without you, what would have been a terrible and what was a terrible and tragic day would have been even more terrible and more tragic. So just very grateful for all of you. And now I'd like to talk a little bit about that video. You've talked a little bit about it in your opening statement, but can you walk us through what is happening in that scene? My understanding is that is a mix of your body camera as well as video from other vantage points.
That's correct. At the beginning, you see me walking into the Capitol. That was after we were driven off of the West Terrace. I think you see me spit on the floor, unfortunately, trying to clear my lungs and mouth of all the CS and OC. You see me preparing my gas mask, donning it, ready to go back out there. And I followed the noise to the tunnel where it was just, you know, wall-to-wall people packed, fighting for with everything they had. It was full of OC and CS gas at the time, and I believe that thickest smoke was from a fire extinguisher. You could see all the residue on the officers who were there. And it's like I said before, you know, they outnumbered us 50-something to one, so it didn't matter how many we defeated. We just had to hold on. We couldn't let anyone through, and they always had essentially an infinite number of replacements. They'd say, you know, we need fresh patriots up here, and there would be more. So we just had to hold until someone came to help. And like I said, once I got to the front, I didn't want any more pressure on the officers behind me. So I tried to insert myself to where I could use the door frame, brace myself, and push forward so I could take back more territory. Unfortunately, that backfired. So once we lost ground, I was unable to retreat. I was crushed up against the door frame. And in my most vulnerable moments, the man in front of me took advantage and beat me in the head, ripped off my gas mask, straining my neck, skull, split my lip open, just everything he could. And at that point, I recognized that if I stayed there, then I was gonna, you know, pass out from lack of oxygen or get dragged out into the crowd and end up like Fanone. So I called for help. You know, I tried to make it clear that, you know, my position was untenable. I had to fall back, and thankfully the other officers heard that, were able to get me out of there. And to the back where I recuperated as best I could before I got back out there again.
Well, it's clear that you suffered immense pain from the assault. It's clear that you were outnumbered, and yet you just said you got back out there again. Tell me, what's worth all of that pain? What was worth it? What were you fighting for that day?
Democracy. You were 40 feet away, 40 yards, whatever. Especially with the razor-thin margins on Democrats and Republicans in the House and Senate, if any single one person was kidnapped or killed, which I have no doubt in my mind is what they intended, that would affect the outcome of legislation and all your duties for years to come. And if that's just one person, what if, you know, more than one person, the difference would be even greater than what should be and will be. And for each other, you know, your immediate concern is the well-being of your colleagues, the other officers who were there fighting beside me. I think I can speak for everyone when I say we worry about each other more than ourselves. That's just in our nature. It's part of why you become a police officer. So, you know, like when Fanon said he was trying to find out who needs help and no one would volunteer, that's just an example of that kind of mindset that we have. So it was for democracy. It was for the men and women of the House and Senate. It was for each other, and it was for the future of the country.
Thank you, Officer Hodges, and thank you all for defending democracy. And I appreciate your testimony, and I appreciate your continued service. With that, I yield back.